Evening. Lovely to be here tonight with you. Welcome to this live lounge extravaganza with Tallulah and myself. I'm delighted to be here and share with you all. Hopefully raise some money for Coda Music Tust, which is where I'm a piano tutor and where we do all sorts of wonderful work. So it's definitely a delight to be here and to play some music tonight. Hopefully, some of you who aren't furloughed might even know what day of the week it is and might even have a Friday feeling. If you have, do grab yourselves a drink and sit back, and hopefully you'll enjoy an evening of 80s music. I have to confess, I've crept a little bit into the decades either side here and there, but I really hope you'll enjoy tonight, and thank you for being here. I'm going to start with slap bang in the middle of the 80s with a song by Duran Duran. What I'll be doing tonight is giving them various piano treatments, so what you'll be hearing won't be quite how you're used to hearing it, but hopefully it'll be enjoyable, and thank you. Thank you. It's hard to know if everyone can hear me okay. I'm going to play a few songs, and then after a little bit I'm going to come and have a look at the comments. I just want to say I've had a lot of help and support from Stephen, our classical guitar tutor. He's been wonderful. He's basically delivered a course on online sound management to me in the course of 2 days flat, and I feel like he's really brought me up to scratch. I don't find technology easy, and I think in this lockdown a lot of us have suddenly had to take a leap, needs must. So learning a whole set of new skills, just want to thank Stephen for his patience and his time. I feel like I've just kind of learnt some very useful skills. So I'm going to carry on in the same vein. In 1982, there were two songs on the number one and number two spot battling it out for the top spot, and thanks to Sylvester Stallone and the Rocky films, Eye of the Tiger kept Duran Duran's Say a Prayer off the top slot. So I thought I'd weave the two together and put them next to each other once more. bring back the memories of kind of frilly shirts and that new romantic era that Duran Duran brought around. So I've popped the two together, and hopefully you're hearing me, because it's very strange doing a gig to a kind of remote audience. My computer did just do something. Okay. you. I feel like it takes a bit of getting used to having an imaginary audience who are there somewhere, and just sort of feeling that, trying to get that connection. I think to get that connection, I need to say hi to a few people who I think are likely to be there. Some of my friends from my host page, we have a WhatsApp page together, some of my girlfriends and I, and we kind of have each other's backs on that page. And I think some of them are here tonight, Tara, which is with Hannah, and then plenty of colleagues, hopefully from Coda, have come to support. I know Deb will be here. And if Phil's feeling a bit better. And just thank you all for being here. There was a thing that happened just on lockdown, that there was so much news about viruses that he kind of got overlooked. And I thought, I want to play a little tribute to Bill Withers tonight, because he passed away at the beginning of lockdown. And what a musical legend he is. Songs like Just the Two of Us, Ain't No Sunshine, various other songs. And I was going to do Just the Two of Us and kind of dedicate it to Lula, who has been keeping me company right throughout lockdown. It's sometimes been a bumpy ride. She has her moods, as do I. But 2 weeks ago, Hayley and Paul did a wonderful gig, and they played Just the Two of Us. So I think I decided to do Ain't No Sunshine, because that's a song that I'm familiar with, and it's really a really lovely song. I'm not used to doing the singing, so to come in and sing in a gig is a bit different for me. I usually accompany the singer. I'm usually the sidekick. Lula's the sidekick. I'm usually the quiet one. And I'm playing at the moment in a lovely duo with Lisa McQuillan, Retro Dolls. So she's usually the vocalist. So singing isn't my usual thing. I will get a drink of water, actually. So I'm going to tell you a bit about Coda in a little while, but hopefully you've located a donate button somewhere. The cause for tonight is Coda Music Tust. I'll be telling you a little bit about what we do there later on. But for now, I'm going to stick with Bill Withers. I'm going to play Ain't No Sunshine.
Ain't no sunshine when he's gone. It's not warm when he's away. Cause there ain't no sunshine when he's gone. This house just ain't no home. Anytime he goes away, wonder this time where he's gone. Wonder if he's gonna stay. Yeah. Ain't no sunshine when he's gone. This house just ain't no home. Anytime he goes away. And I know. I gotta leave young thing alone. Cause there ain't no sunshine when he's gone. Thank you. sunshine when he's gone. Only dark when he's away. 'Cause there ain't no sunshine when he's gone. This house just ain't no home anytime he goes away. Anytime he goes away. Away. Anytime he goes away.
So you wouldn't believe it, but Phil Withers, when his hit Ain't No Sunshine happened, which was the year I was born, which wasn't in the 80s, by the way, he was actually an airline mechanic working for Boeing 747s, fitting toilets in Boeing 747s. And so he had that hit, and then it was kind of, he was definitely taking off from then on. He'll be very missed, I'm sure, in the music world. I'm gonna come and have a look at the comments. I've asked Stephen if once I'd done a song, if he'd come and have a little look and write if it's okay, the balance and everything, because it's quite hard to hear what you're doing and gauge it from outside of the box. I feel like you're all in my machine. It's really strange. I'm going to come and have a quick read of the comments. Have a look for the button if you can. If you're able to give the Coda Music Tust, that would be brilliant. I'm going to come and have a little look and see what Stephen's saying. Feel better now because I know there's somebody there for a start. I'm glad I went and had a little look. Sorry I left you on your own, but that feels a bit better. Hello Luinian, my sister and brother-in-law. Hello Sharon Welling, my in one of my groups that I teach, my piano groups at Coda. Hello Hayley. Lots of hellos. I've got to say the biggest hello, or the furthest away hello, goes to my lovely friend Angela, who is watching in Korea. This is the amazing thing of technology, isn't it? It's just incredible. Hi, Angela. And a big hello and love to Larry and Yoko in Glasgow and so many others. I just seen Jonathan. He's probably saying something really cheeky. And it's lovely to be here. I'm going to carry on. I'm going to sing a more gentle one. I've got a real love of Fleetwood Mac. I just think they're brilliant. And I'm going to say, talking of sort of lockdowns, I know it's been quite difficult for people who are locked indoors, you know, trying to educate children, trying to work from home, you know, all of those different challenges, and, you know, and living in close quarters for, you know, so cooped up together isn't easy. As Tallulah and I know, sometimes it's very challenging. And I don't know if you've ever seen a film, Single White Female, but there were a few moments between Tallulah and myself, but I must tell you, she's actually armless.
Oh.
Wanted to talk a bit about Coda Music Tust. We are over in Walkford. When I think about Coda, I just think of it, the sun shines out and I'm coming in the car park and it's an old farm. And when I think of it, it's sunshine, there's a meadow of wildflowers. And I want to say hello to Jan because I know Jan is in the chat box. Jan grows all sorts of wonderful homegrown vegetables, and it's like a big square with various buildings. And down the bottom end, we have Owain and Rachel. They're working on the days that I'm working, and they're doing music therapy in some beautifully equipped rooms that are very calm, and they do their fine work down there where they're just slightly tucked away in the piece, and they do wonderful work. And then we have various groups that are just so brilliant. I love it on a Wednesday night. When I finish, I always go and have a sneaky listen, because Stuart will be doing the ukulele band, and they'll be singing some amazing memory earworm that I haven't heard for years and years, like Pina Colada song or something mad like that, and they will just be having so much fun, and you can feel the fun coming out of the room. And we have choirs, we have a jazz band. So we do such a variety of work. A lot of it is in the community. We work with the elderly. We use music to help people with dementia. Really important work with the way that music can ground people in a memory and a soothing feeling, because it's familiar. It's very powerful. We also work in special schools across Dorset and Hampshire, and using music to reach people. We also have a wonderful project that meets, I think it's a Tuesday when I come in, Beautiful Sounds. They're all gathered playing, adults with learning disabilities, having just making such good music. And they really enjoy coming, and they make a great sound. So we do all these different things. There's even a fiddle orchestra that meets in Boscombe and Bournemouth. I think Jack Maguire has just retired, actually. I'm not sure who's taking it now. So all of these wonderful things that go on at Coda. And just not to forget as well that it wouldn't tick along like that if it wasn't for Deb and Amy and Marina and Phil, who are behind the scenes keeping it all going. But we are a charity, so that's why we're having all these fundraisers to help us keep up our wonderful work after lockdown is finished. So that's a synopsis of Coda. If you've got any questions, Phil's probably in there. I think he is. It's hard to tell because there's a few people who are admins of our site. It's hard to tell who's who, but I'm pretty sure Phil will be here. If you've got any questions about Coda, or any ideas for Coda, or if you want to contact Coda and get us to do music in your community, then do so. So I'm going to crack on with the next song. Another Fleetwood Mac song. So yeah, I am venturing out of the 80s. This is 1977, and it's You Make Loving Fun. It's a lovely song. And again, I've given it a bit of a treatment. I just need to check. You like to laugh. Wonderful you make me happy with the things you do. Oh, oh, can it be so? Oh, this feeling follows me wherever I go. Could it believe in miracles? Never
have a feeling it's time to try. Never did believe in the ways of magic, and I'm beginning to wonder why. Don't break the spell. It would be different, and you know it will. You make loving fun, and I don't have to tell you, but you're the only one. You make loving fun. Loving fun. All I wanna do is you. You make loving fun. All I wanna do is you.
So, just wanna sort of say a little bit more about the 80s. You know, the things that we remember about it, the good and the bad. You know, the thing that sticks in my mind is the Falklands War and how that felt to me as a child, so not so good. And then you had that sort of materialistic side, the yuppies, and songs like Material Girl by Madonna, which just sort of, when I listen to it, it sounds so empty. And, you know, so obviously things we liked and didn't like. And, of course, there was Margaret Thatcher. And I just wanted to say that it's just gone 7:30, and unlike Margaret Thatcher, I won't outstay my welcome tonight. I'll have you out of here by 8 o'clock. And I'm going to play a song by Echo and the Bunnymen called Killing Moon.
Short and sweet.
and my lovely girlfriends out there, especially this one is especially for Tara, for Hayley, for Hope, for Louise, and for Lil Vic. This one's for you. And everyone else as well. I don't know if my friend Hugh is watching. If he's not, I'll be telling him he has to watch, because I wanted to play Natural Woman for Hugh. It was composed by Carole King in the year I was born, and Hugh loves Carole King, and I love Carole King, and hopefully some of you love Carole King too, and just want to say this song is not about Tallulah. Looking out in the morning rain, I used to feel uninspired. When I thought I'd have to face another day, Lord, it made me feel so tired. Now I'm no longer doubtful of what I'm living for. And if it makes me happy, I'll come back and do some more. You make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. And when my soul was in the lost and found, you came along to claim it. I didn't know just what was wrong with me,
till your steps help me name it. Now I'm no longer doubtful of what I'm living for, and if it makes me happy, I'll come back and do some more. You make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. Ooh, baby, what you done to me? Ooh, you make me feel so good inside, and I just wanna be close to you. You make me feel so alive, 'cause you make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. You make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. Natural woman. Oh,
sorry to leave that out of the book. I'm going to play a bit of Elton John, because you can't really play a poppy gig without a bit of Elton John. And I'm glancing at the time, and I'm going to have to save my Tina Turner impression for another time, which you'll have to stay wondering about what that was all about. And I'm really pleased, because it was something I was a little unsure about. And I think Elton John would be a better bet. So, yeah, Rocket Man.
She packed my bags last night, pre-flight. 0:09 a.m. I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. I miss the earth so much, I miss my wife. It's lonely out in space on such a timeless flight. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again to find I'm not the man I think I am at home. Oh no, 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 I'm a rocket man. Rocket man, burning out his fuse out here alone. Mars ain't the time or place to raise your kids. In fact, it's cold as hell, and there's no one there to raise them. If you did, and all this science I don't understand, it's just my job 8 days a week. A rocket man, rocket man. I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again to find I'm not the man I think I am at home. Oh no, 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 I'm a rocket man. without his views out here alone. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time.
I just want to talk a little bit about that sort of thing of people having such eclectic taste in music. You know, when someone asks you, what music do you like? It's a really hard thing to answer. It's almost like there's just too much. My lovely dad was a avid classical music lover. He had a wonderful vinyl record collection, and he would seek out the exact recording that he wanted. He may have heard something on Radio 3 and he'd want that particular conductor, that orchestra and that soloist, and he'd go on a mission to find the record he wanted. And it was very, very rarely that he would listen to any sort of popular music. In fact, usually it was a case of, you're making too much noise with your bass line, Vivienne, please turn it down. However, when I played this song, he used to come in and say, I like that song, who is that? And it was George Michael's Careless Whisper. And I'm just going to do something with my computer. This is one that my dad liked very much. Yeah, me and technology, not always good. Most comfortable on a real piano. But miking up real pianos isn't easy. I think there was a gig a few weeks ago. We had James, and it was lovely because he was playing the piano he'd learnt to play on as a child, which was really nice, and he'd mic'd it up really well. I am sitting on the piano stool that I sat on to learn as a child, but nothing else. So here's George Michael. Whoops, I'm going to start there. Let's get one, please.